I'm going to create a couple of cloud replication rules. Here's my starting state. I've got two buckets. My source bucket has a couple of files in it, and my destination bucket is empty. So I go into cloud replication and I hit replicate your data. Now I'll just go with the default name here, replication US West, because I want to replicate data within this B2 region. So I select my source bucket, switch my destination region to US West. And since I want to stay in the same account here, I'm not going to authenticate to a different account. I'm just going to select my destination bucket. So in this example, I might be replicating some production data in order to run maybe some staging tests on it. So let's say next. And I can just check that everything is as I want it, replicating from the source to the destination and create that replication. Now, if I go back to looking at the buckets, we can see that not much has happened yet. The default when you set up a replication rule in the web interface is that existing files are copied, but they're put into a queue. So it can take anything from a few minutes to a few hours for those to copy across, depending on how much data you have and how busy the system is. But let's try and add some new data to this source bucket. So let's say upload, and I'm going to select, let's see, what have we got here? I'm going to say, okay, let's get that nice logo and maybe a 5 megabyte file. Okay, so they've uploaded. And now I can go into the file details here and I can see that the replication status is pending. But what we should see is in just a few seconds that these new files replicate over to the destination bucket. Oh, and there they are, in fact. And if I look at this one here, Backblaze logo, I can see that its replication status is replica. So I can see that that replication took place there. Let's replicate some data across regions. I have a second account here through the magic of an incognito browser window. And this one's logged into an account in the EU central region. In fact, we can go into buckets here and see that the endpoint for the bucket says EU central 003. Okay, so my buckets are empty over here. Let's configure a second replication rule. So I can say again, I want to replicate from, let's see, we'll call this US to EU. And again, I'll use the same source bucket. And here I'm in EU Central and I need to say, I want to authenticate an existing account. One password saves me from having to share my credentials with you all. And now I can select a bucket from that account. So you see they're the same list of buckets there. So I'm going to say EU destination. Check that everything looks right, replicating from US source to EU destination and create my replication rule. And again, we can go into the browser here and say upload a couple more files. So I'm going to select what is the 1 and the 10 I think I still need to do. So let's upload those. They upload, just takes a few seconds, a little bit longer for that 10 megabyte file. Okay, so again, I should be able to go over to the European Union over here, the Backblaze data center in Amsterdam. And again, I can just go into that EU destination and, oh, there they are. Again, I can go in, I can see on this one here, it should say replication completed. And this one here, it will say that is the replica. And if we go over to the US destination, of course, that rule is still in operation. So we have four files there. And those existing files, the extra two will catch up on this side. And the four files that existed when we created this rule, again, they'll catch up over the next few minutes or hours. And by tomorrow, everything should be in synchronization. So there you have it. Backblaze Cloud Replication. Thanks for watching.